We have very special guests with us, and we have also the professors from the HKU University, and we have so many others who have joined us live from many parts of the world. I'm sure this is the same experience. All of them are very proud of all these students, and of course, Dimitris Lambrianos, where is he? Yeah, he's behind. For having done a wonderful job of training and teaching these students. May I request His Excellency from Germany to speak to us and speak to the children and tell them about what is your feeling.
Thank you, Sadhguru. You know, I'm a diplomat since 30 years now, and normally I'm used to speak, but children, you leave me speechless. Thank you so much. It was an amazing concert. I didn't expect anything similar to that. And I think all of you who performed tonight, all of you actually who performed before, who are behind the scenes and who did that tremendous work to put this on a stage, thank you so much. It was an absolute stunning experience. And I love to hear also music pieces from my own country, also from Greece and from so many countries around the world. A wonderful variety of jazz, which is my favorite music actually, classical music, modern music, film music, all the influences which come together here. You take this and one can feel sitting over there that you always feel it, that you like to do what you're doing. So continue to do what you're doing, continue to strive for the best. Thank you so much for inviting me tonight, and my wife and our friend Gundi. She actually, I think she can cherish even more because she's a pianist, so that is something where I will hear her opinion on it later. So thank you for having us tonight, and all the best for all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, we truly appreciate his words of encouragement and appreciation. I must also inform our esteemed guests that we have children here from different countries as well. We have some students, can you stand up, who are from other countries? We have people from Portuguese, we're from Poland, we are from Singapore, we're from Nigeria, we are from Dubai, Middle East, we are from Australia, we have from Fiji. Canada, from Fiji Islands. So we have plenty of children from other countries as well who have joined us. Of course, Mr. Massimo, he's from Italy. He's a trumpetist somewhere behind. So we have also children from other countries, and they don't feel this difference that we are from another country and these children are from rural Karnataka or India. They all work together like one single unit. That's what orchestra is about. You know, we lose our individuality and we merge in the collectiveness of the music. That is the message for the world also. If we forget our individual egos and, you know, selfishness, and we all work together, the world will be much more harmonious. And that is the message of this orchestra as well. Would you like to speak a word or two? Because now you had a Greek music too, and I almost thought you will get up and dance, because Greek people love Greek people love food, music, and dance. So.
Thank you. Let me say first, namaskar, and sankranti ki hardik shubhkamanai. Sadhguru, please allow me to convey warmest greetings from the Ambassador of Greece in India, Mr. Dimitrios Ioannou, and a warm message of friendship, because as you all know, India and Greece are very good friends. Bharat aur Yunan bahut acche dost hai. And it's a blessing to be here tonight to support and admire the inspiring and life-changing work that is taking place in your institution, to admire the talent of these kids, and to be equally you know, impressed by the quality of the music, and of course the wonderful direction. We're glad there's a great connection to it. We want to thank warmly the director, distinguished musician Lavrenos. And I want to thank you so warmly for having played a music that talks to the heart and soul of every Greek. I really want to thank you. It's the best performance I've heard. Just thank you for showing us once again the blessing that is India. Is saman ke liye bahut dhanyavad. Thank you.
Oh, very nice. Thank you. She has picked up a lot of Hindi. And I said that languages connect us to each other. But music is a language which is universal, and that connects everyone. We also enjoy the Greek music as much as she does. So also the Turkish, so also the Europeans, also the American, and the Oriental. So this is the beauty of music. It transcends all barriers. And through music, we can unite the world. This is our idea. May I invite the professors from HK University also to please join us. And Dr. Manjunath, and we are very glad to have, led by Dr. Nair, all the team members, please do join us on the stage. So they are also working, going to work. These children are very lucky because they are also going to get some training with the classical musicians. They also play jazz and other styles. So they will also get trained together. So there is an opportunity for you to go to Netherlands and learn something. Is it a good idea? You know where is Netherlands? That's in Europe. Please do come here. Please come. And our children are also going to play in Singapore in the month of September. Oh, wow. So they are taking the whole thing. Okay. This is Dr. Manjunath. He's a... Please come on. Dr. Manjunath is a violinist, very accomplished, and is from a tradition of violinists. And he is the one who is also on the board of a music college. And he's brought everyone together to have some kind of a working and relationship and exchange program where we can learn and grow together in music or the Western and thing. So I will also request Dr. Norris, please speak a word or two.
Well, I have two things I would like to say. First of all, congratulations to Dimitris and all of you performers tonight. It was glorious. All the different instruments, these are instruments from the West. We know these in orchestras and jazz bands, and to see them here in India, and what great quality instruments and the way they are played, and such a great level from all of you. It's really inspiring and wonderful to see. I heard so many great individual voices and so much great teamwork, the way you all play together. And that's really the beauty of the music, is the way we play music together. It brings us closer together, as you say, Swami. And that's really the joy of music, is playing music together. And the second thing I want to say is I really, really enjoyed it. That's all. Yeah. And I was laughing and just so happy the whole time. And all these nice arrangements and all the players. It really just brought a smile to my face. So thank you so much for that, all of you.
Dr. Manjunath, a word from you.
Pranam Satguru, and then I have absolutely, just like honorable guests made his remarks, I'm speechless. And the way, this is precisely what myself and then Professor, we were talking about. Considering the background, that none of them has any musical background, right? All of them have come from different places, and then most of them, even probably, they had never ever seen any one of these instruments earlier in their lives. And then bringing all of them, and then making them learn music, learn their instrument. You see, learning music is different, and learning the technical skills, and then having a mastery over the instrument is totally different. It's a double headache. And taking all the headaches, and then making them such a beautiful musicians, is really, really Herculean task. Thank you so much, and then congratulations, Dimitris. It's a wonderful thing. And I'm pretty sure you all agree with me, you know, when we come here in this wonderful divine place, even the music and musicians, we all honestly become ourselves instruments. Wherein this inspiration, the power, and the creativity, and blessings, every single one of them comes from here. Thank you so much.
We also have an exchange of interest, letter of interest between the two universities. And I do not know where to place Dr. Manjunath, but I have placed him on our side for time being. Yes, it's just an exchange of interest, letter of interest. I thought you all are here, so it's a Nice. You made it. Yeah, you can give it to him on behalf. Yeah. That's how East and West can work together. I always believe in that because I think that is the need of the hour. And music can be the fastest way of joining them together. I don't depend too much on bureaucracy, you see. I depend on music, though. So that's our way of taking the, you know, the message of unity. So I look forward to working together. It doesn't mean that we shouldn't work together. But, you know, you can be channels of this message through your music, through your bureaucratic work, through your instrumentation. Let us take this sound of oneness, this message of oneness to the whole world. That is the need of the hour. And we will celebrate it through music. And I'm sure I'll bring some of these children to Netherlands and maybe your students, and they all together can perform some of the pieces there another time. I'm looking forward to that. Yes.
The first piece that we will be presenting this evening is Chariots of Fire. The Greek composer Vangelis penned this for the 1981 film Chariots of Fire. For this piece, we have Mrinal Sai on the grand piano, and I will be playing the harp.
Thank you.
next piece, this evening, will be the final countdown, originally performed and released in 1986 by the Swedish rock band Europe and written by Joey Tempest. It was a massive hit around the world. For this song, we have Rishi Gopinath on the electric guitar and Kishan on the keytar, the final countdown.
Thank you.
The next composition we will be presenting this evening is a Badinery from Suite No. 2 in B minor. Composed by Johann Sebastian Bach, the famed Baroque composer, this particular type of composition is known for its lively and playful nature. On the lead flutes for this piece, we have Ashwin Sundaram and Harshit Krishna. The next piece the orchestra will be playing is Take Five, which is a highly influential jazz standard composed by the saxophonist Paul Desmond. It was released in 1959 by the David Brubeck Quartet. Over time, it became the best-selling single in the history of jazz music and is well known to this day for its offbeat rhythm. We have Mr. Dimitris on the grand piano and Rishi Gopinath on the alto saxophone for this piece.
Thank you.
Chopin's Nocturne No. 20 in C sharp minor. This is a solo piano piece composed by Frederick Chopin. This work was dedicated to his elder sister, Ludwika Chopin. This piece will be a solo performance by Ashwin Sundaram on the grand piano, presenting to you Chopin's Nocturne. Now, we will have Prem Sai pursuing his third year of Bachelor in Vedic Studies, speaking to all of us.
Good evening. My name is Prem Sai, and I'm pursuing my final year in the Bachelor's of Vedic Studies at the Sri Sathya Sai University for Human Excellence. It is said that Nadam is the breath of God, while Vedam is the very voice of God. Nadam is a Sanskrit term that translates into sound. Sound is considered to be the closest representation of divinity in Indian culture. Vedam refers to the knowledge that was revealed to the sages and seers of the past after severe penance and contemplation. Together, they form the very bedrock of Indian culture and civilization. The Sri Sathya Sai University for Human Excellence, along with the regular courses in Bachelor's of Ved, along with the regular courses in Sciences and Humanities, offers the courses of Bachelor's in Vedic Studies and Bachelor's in Performing Arts to all the students who are interested in pursuing these subjects. I consider myself very fortunate that both Nadam and Vedam are fundamental parts of my life. The Bachelor's of Vedic Studies program was launched by Sadhguru to facilitate the establishment of Sanatana Dharma. Sanatana Dharma is a concept that emerged in ancient India, which speaks of the unity of all existence as the one eternal truth. In this course, we are nurtured to pursue an in-depth study of all the ancient scriptures of India from a modern perspective. Here, I have come to learn and appreciate the depth and the practicality of the wisdom of the Vedas. I consider it a privilege that I have been allowed to learn these scriptures and believe that it is my responsibility to teach what I have learned to many others across the world. This is my third year in the Sai Symphony Orchestra. Initially, when I joined this orchestra, I thought that music was the only thing that I could learn here. But now I realize that music is only one of the many aspects of our learning in this orchestra. In my 3 years here, I've observed that there are fundamentally three aspects that hold this orchestra together. The first aspect is love for God. This orchestra comprises of students from different backgrounds. We have some students from some of the most rural parts of India. At the same time, we have students from different parts of the world. When these students come here, they forget all their differences in cultures and backgrounds and are united by the one purpose of playing good music to please God. The second aspect is gratitude. Gratitude to all those whose efforts and sacrifices made it possible for us to get this opportunity. This gratitude manifests as discipline among the students. We believe that it is our responsibility to take care of the instruments that have been given to us and effectively use our time to learn these instruments. The third aspect is a sense of duty. We believe that it is our duty to teach what we have learned to our younger brothers so that this process of learning never stops. This aspect is unique not only to the orchestra, but to all our educational institutions. This tradition, where the elder students teach what they have learned to their younger students, helps in establishing the culture of our institution in the hearts of all the students. This orchestra stands as a testimony to the power of love and sacrifice. I would like to offer my gratitude to Sadhguru for creating this platform where all of us can constantly learn and grow. To Dimitri sir, who's been patiently bearing with all our mistakes and continuously encouraging us to become better in whatever we do. To all the elders and the benefactors of this orchestra and organization who've been working tirelessly behind the scenes to make these events possible. Thank you, Sairam.
Composed by Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart, one of the all-time greatest Western classical composers. The next song presented by the Sai Symphony Orchestra is Turkish March, also titled Rondo a la Turca, meaning the Turkish way or the Turkish March. This composition is the final movement of Mozart's piano sonata number 11. We have Jeevan Sai on the grand piano presenting to you Turkish March. Our next piece is the theme composed by Lalo Schifrin in an odd rhythm, which won the best instrumental theme at the 10th Grammy Awards. We will be presenting to you the theme from the TV and movie series Mission Impossible. On this piece, we will have Dimitris Lambrianos on the grand piano and trumpet, Rishi Gopinath on electric guitar, and Sai Shankar Narayanan on drums. In addition, we will also have Sai Nandan and Ayush beatboxing with an introduction of Likit Sai doing the Konna Kol.
Tak, 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 tak